गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी.
गुड आफ्टरनून.
आई एम डॉक्टर कीर्ति.
आई एम डॉक्टर ब्रिज मक्कर.
सर, देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेरीज रिगार्डिंग डायबिटीज इन द माइंड्स ऑफ ऑल ऑफ अस. सो नाउ टुडे वी वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड डायबिटीज फ्रॉम यू.
श्योर.
सो वी वांट टू नो व्हाट इज डायबिटीज.
सो शैल वी कंटिन्यू इन इंग्लिश और हिंदी इंग्लिश मिक्स कर लें.
मिक्स कर लें. गुड.
ओके. So diabetes, basically it is a very important disease that we are seeing in our day to day life now. Diabetes is a disease which is characterized by increase in blood glucose levels, and this increase in blood glucose level, though it may be silent, it may not be causing any problems in the near term, but has very long lasting adverse effects on the health and leads to a number of complications which affect your kidneys, your eyes, your brain, your heart, your feet, practically all, each and every part of body to a smaller or larger extent. And not only that, leads to a greatly increased risk of developing heart disease and early death. So diabetes, typically is understood, or it is more or less synonymous with high blood sugars. But it is not just the high blood sugar that is important, it is the implications of that high blood sugar that are more important, which lead to a number of chronic crippling complications and increase in the risk of early death.
You mean to say, we need to have good control of sugar to avoid complications, taking care of each and every part, each and every complication, we need to take care of all these things.
So once we say that somebody has diabetes, किसी को अगर sugar है, तो पहली चीज है कि sugar खाली एक चीज है जिसको हमने handle करना है. इसके अलावा there are multiple comorbid conditions in diabetes patients which also need to be addressed. So if somebody has diabetes, there is very good chance that person will be having high blood pressure, high levels of cholesterol, there may be associated thyroid problem, there may be associated deficiency of vitamin D. So there are multiple things which are coming up, and these people are prone to get silent heart attacks also. So we have to look at the patient in totality and not just the blood sugar levels. Of course, the control of blood sugar is important. It is very important to bring down the glucose and keep them in normal range, making sure that patients do not get low sugars also, because they are also acute emergency. So we have to maintain the sugars in a desired range. At the same time, we have to also assess whether there is a need to treat blood pressure, cholesterol, thyroid, vitamin D, and so on.
So you mean to say we need to have a holistic approach to it?
Yes.
And we need to have a support system for the patient, a teamwork for the patient at the back.
Yes, very important.
So next thing, when do you say a person has diabetes? I mean to say when?
So diabetes basically is defined on the basis of blood sugar levels. That is what I said. It is more or less synonymous with blood sugar levels. It is marked by increase in blood glucose levels. So if the blood sugar level or blood glucose level in fasting state is more than 100,
okay,
so we can divide the situation as normal, pre-diabetes and diabetes, depending on the blood glucose levels. So somebody has a fasting blood glucose level. When we say fasting, that means person should have fasted for at least 8 hours. If the fasting blood glucose levels is more than 100 and less than 126, it is defined as pre-diabetes or impaired fasting glucose. And if it is more than 126, it is defined as diabetes. Similarly, if the person has a post-meal blood glucose level between 140 to 200, it is defined as impaired glucose tolerance or pre-diabetes. Or if it is more than 200, it is defined as diabetes. So fasting more than 126, PP value मोर देन 200 और ए रैंडम ग्लूकोज वैल्यू ऑफ मोर देन 200 मेजर्ड एनी टाइम इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ क्लासिकल सिम्टम्स ऑफ डायबिटीज विच इज इंक्रीज थर्स्ट इंक्रीज हंगर वेट लॉस एंड इंक्रीज यूरिनेशन और अब A1C लेवल विच गिव्स यू अ इंडिकेशन ऑफ एवरेज ग्लूकोज ओवर लास्ट 3 मंथ्स ऑफ मोर देन 6.5%. एनी ऑफ दीज इज इंडिकेटिव ऑफ डायग्नोसिस ऑफ डायबिटीज.
सो देयर इज अ वेरी बिग क्वेश्चन मार्क इन माइंड ऑफ पीपल. सी पीपल वर्किंग विद MNCs, दे हैव रिवर्स स्लीप साइकिल. सो व्हाट अबाउट शुगर टेस्टिंग इन दीज पीपल? सी इन द डे टाइम दे आर स्लीपिंग.
सो it has nothing to do with sleep. When we say fasting glucose, fasting means person should have fasted for 8 hours.
That may be in the daytime also or in the night.
8 hours fasting. Typically it is morning sample.
Okay.
But if you are looking at fasting, it should be more than 8 hours of fasting. Then post meal value is 2 hours after the last meal. So again, it is the time duration or the time interval between food and glucose testing, not the time of the day. For making a diagnosis of diabetes, ideally it should be measured after 75 grams of glucose, which is given as meal, and you measure the post meal glucose 2 hours after the intake of glucose.
So for making a diagnosis, you say 75 gram glucose is the ideal, but is fasting and PP, what we say is nashte ke 2 ghante baad, with a normal meal which a person is taking, is it a diagnostic or
so
not?
So that is what we call as post meal, not post glucose. If post meal is again more than 200 and person has symptoms, or if you have two values more than 24 hours apart, then they are diagnostic of that.
Right. So coming to the next question. Does every person who comes to you presents with symptoms, or maybe at times they are asymptomatic?
So there are two types of diabetes. Before we will have to clarify here. So there is type 1 diabetes, which is caused by a destruction of the insulin secreting cells in pancreas due to autoimmunity or infection. We don't go into details here. So most important thing is there is destruction of beta cells in pancreas, which leads to acute deficiency of insulin. And this usually happens in children and young adults. And this type of diabetes is associated with marked symptoms of increased thirst, increased urination, increased hunger and weight loss. So type 1 classically presents with very remarkable symptoms. Type 2 diabetes is caused by increase in insulin resistance and partial deficiency of insulin or a relative deficiency of insulin. So here typically the symptoms are missing or non-existent. And just to make one more point here, type 1 diabetes in India accounts for only about 3% of the diabetes patients. 97% of the patients with diabetes are type 2 diabetes. And of these 97% patients, most of the patients are either asymptomatic, they do not have any symptoms. They are usually diagnosed or during routine health checks or when they are investigated for some other disease process. Some of them may have symptoms which may not be marked, and some of them will have classical symptoms, but majority will not have any symptoms.
Sir, we'll be covering this type 1 and type 2 in further episodes of ours, but I just want to ask one question from you which usually we people encounter. Patient will ask, but sir, mujhe aaj tak nahi pata meri diabetes kaun si hai.
So again, very simple way to decide is, if it started at young age, patient is lean and thin, had all the symptoms, classical symptoms, and the sugar levels were very high at the level time of diagnosis, it is likely to be type 1.
Okay.
So, for all practical purposes, if you are diagnosed डायबिटीज इज डायग्नोस्ड अंडर द एज ऑफ 25 इयर्स इन ए नॉन ओबीस इंडिविजुअल एंड विद रिमार्केबल सिम्टम्स वी ट्रीट दिस एज टाइप 1 अनलेस वी प्रूव दैट इट इज नॉट टाइप सो अनलेस proved otherwise it is considered type 1.
Right.
Of course there are tests which can differentiate between type 1 and type 2. All patients who are obese or overweight who get diabetes after the age of 25 who do not have symptoms even if the sugar levels are high they are more often than not or most of the cases will be type 2. Now if you have to differentiate then there are certain tests like C-peptide or GAD antibodies but C-peptide should be done only once the sugar level is controlled otherwise it can be false positive or false negative and you may not get a conclusion.
Have you seen in your practice a lean diabetic whom you have considered to be a type 1 and turned out to be a type 2?
There are situations where you will find people who are lean and having type 2 or people who are obese and having type 1 or there are some genetic types like MODY which we don't need to go into details
right,
here.
Sir.
But largely, if the person is childhood onset or young adulthood onset or adolescent onset in lean thin individuals with marked symptoms is type 1. Absence of symptoms. Higher age group, higher body weight, most likely type 2.
So you mean to say if a type 2, I'm supposedly saying a type 2 obese patient comes to you with a high sugar, can you expect him to be ketone positive or he's comfortable?
He may be totally asymptomatic, will not have ketones.
He can come with 500s and 600 sugars without ketones.
It can be.
Sir, should we take the questions in the session
after? Yes, we can keep taking
Sir, there's a question from Veena Gandhi. As my diabetes fluctuates regularly, can I take corona vaccine? My age is 67.
See, all diabetic patients must take corona vaccine. That is one thing which you should keep in mind because all diabetes patients are at very high risk of getting all infections, especially chest infections. So, COVID vaccine is actually... you are in the high risk group and you should be taking COVID vaccine. Now, even if your sugars are fluctuating, you have to go for vaccination. You should not delay vaccination. More important is that you should focus on control of your sugar. Why they are fluctuating? Find out the cause, control it.
So, what's your take on Ecosprin?
So, there will be a lot of patients who are on Ecosprin or other blood thinners.
Now
they are all high risk
and
they need to be vaccinated. So I think this is a concern because there can be a small bleed at the site of injection or there is a risk of bleeding but we do not stop giving injections to these patients. All patients who are on blood thinners keep getting injections routinely. We give them other vaccines also. So they should be going for vaccination. Only thing as a precautionary measure maybe they can skip the dose of blood thinner on day before the vaccination and start it again day after the vaccination.
So there's a question from Sandeep Sharma. Doctor, if fasting is 120 to 145 and PP is around 100, what is the significance prediction?
So this can be, this is a possible scenario. This happens in quite a few patients. So, I think... if we go into the details of how this happens will be confusing for most of the people, but just keep in mind that you can have higher fasting as compared to your post-meal glucose value. Normally people feel that fasting should be lower and post-meal should be higher. But there are quite a few patients who will have higher fasting glucose and lower post-meal glucose. Because they have higher insulin resistance, so they produce more glucose during night from the liver. But after the meal, their insulin secretion is pretty good and it suppresses the glucose level.
Okay.
So they have higher resistance while the beta cell function is better.
Question from Bablu Chaudhary. Sir, I am type 1 diabetic with 12-year-old आई हैव अ टाइप 1 डायबिटिक 12 ईयर ओल्ड किड टेकिंग इंसुलिन 4 टाइम्स इन विच ट्रसीबा इज देयर एट द नाइट. द प्रॉब्लम इज रेगुलर हाइपोग्लाइसीमिया. बॉडी इज शिवरिंग रेगुलरली एंड वीकनेस. सर व्हाट शुड वन डू एट दैट कंडीशन?
सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज आई थिंक डोजेज एडजस्टमेंट इज रिक्वायर्ड. नाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज इफ यू हैव टाइप 1 पर्सन अ चाइल्ड जस्ट गिविंग इंसुलिन इज नॉट सफिशियंट. यू हैव टू कीप मॉनिटरिंग ग्लूकोज. You have to keep adjusting the dosage depending on the meal intakes. You have to have a guidance from a dietitian how to plan the meals. You need to be educated on how to adjust insulin dosage on day to day basis. You should be in touch with your doctor on regular basis. And if nothing is working, then you can consider getting an insulin pump also. But most important thing is, even with pump, you have to keep in mind that hypoglycemia can occur. Though with the automated pumps, something like the newer versions, they have an auto suspend function. When the glucose goes low, the insulin injection will stop and it will resume once the sugar starts going up. But you can control with Tresiba and regular acting insulin, provided you understand how much insulin is required with the meal. You can do the calorie counts or the carb counts, and also you have to time the injections properly with the meals, and you have to have some kind of regulation about the meal intake also.
So you mean to say in type 1 patients also lifestyle, proper timing of medication,
absolutely,
and proper diet, what we say is the mainstay of the treatment.
Absolutely.
And at the time of hypos, we have to manage of our own and
yes,
consult the doctor.
Yes.
Sir, Kiran Gulati is asking, his messages are coming regarding the second dose of COVID after 6 to 8 weeks. I think it was previously 4 to 8. Sir, maybe she's asking there's a little change in the schedule of COVID vaccination. Previously it was...
So, see, one thing you have to keep in mind that everything relating to COVID is new to the whole medical profession and the whole of world. There is no way we can decide that vaccination interval should have been 8 weeks to begin with. It is only during the observations we have seen that initial studies, the people who could not get vaccinated at 4 weeks and got vaccinated at 6 weeks possibly had better levels of antibodies or the similar level of antibodies, and they will do fine. And similarly, the observations have shown now that there is not much difference between 4 weeks and 8 weeks. It is not that everybody should get at 8 weeks. Even if you are getting at 8 weeks, your immunity is likely to be similar. So that is why the phasing has been done. UK basically, to start with, they increased the dosing interval just to ensure that first dose is given to larger number of people rather than giving two doses to smaller number of people. Because after 1 week, you need double the numbers of vaccines. Because the numbers you have already vaccinated, you need a shot for them and you need a shot for the new people. So just to make sure that the rational utilization of vaccine, they injected more number of people with the first dose, giving a longer interval for the second dose. Now if you go by the antibody production, by 3 to 4 weeks, almost 70% of the antibody levels are achieved even with single shot. So, every country has tried to use the vaccine in a best possible manner to conserve or to make best utilization of the resources they have. But with the more and more data or more and more observational data coming up, we are becoming wiser, we are understanding more things. And now the current scenario is that you can use the second shot anytime between 4 to 8 weeks. And some studies are showing even up to 12 weeks.
Right. I think we've taken the questions. Now coming to my question, sir. I'll not talk about type 1. I'll talk about type 2. What are the indications that a person has to get tested for diabetes when he's asymptomatic?
So, first thing is we Indians are at high risk of diabetes. As Indian ethnic population, we have high risk of diabetes. And we get diabetes at lower level of body mass index or lower body weight compared to Western population.
We are thin fatty.
So, the current recommendation for type 2 diabetes is that you should get screened for diabetes whenever you are visiting a primary health care clinic or a doctor. Whenever you are visiting a doctor for whatever reason, you should get checked for diabetes.
Don't miss the opportunity.
Yes. Second thing is 30 to 35 years plus, everybody should get annual screening for diabetes. For Westerns, the recommendation is 45 years. 45 years plus, you should get screening for diabetes. If you are negative, then you can do every 3 years. For Indians, we recommend that we should get screening. If there is no other risk factor, then maybe after the age of 45 years. But if you have risk factor, like you are overweight, obese, high risk, have cholesterol abnormality, high blood pressure, whatever, any risk factor, smoker, then you should have screening started early, and opportunistic screening at every single opportunity when you are visiting a medical facility.
Right, sir. So when to call one a obese? It is a eye test or you have some?
Very difficult not very difficult, actually very easy. If you look at a person, you will know that person is overweight or obese, so you can make an impression, and largely you are correct. But otherwise you have to calculate the body mass index. That is the only parameter on which we define obesity now. And for Indians, the BMI cutoffs are lower, so anybody having BMI more than 25, you can calculate BMI from so many calculators on Google. If the BMI is more than 25, you are overweight. If your BMI is more than 23, you are overweight. If your BMI is more than 25, you are obese.
So there was a question from Kiran Gulati. From Kiran Gulati only. Weight loss is only because of diabetes? Maybe she wanted to ask, I am a diabetic and I am having weight loss.
So weight loss can be because of multiple reasons. So weight loss with diabetes occurs only if somebody has very high levels of glucose persisting for a long duration of time, and we are talking of type 2 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes, of course, they present with weight loss, that they are usually children. The adults with high levels of glucose persisting for longer duration of time, then only you will see weight loss. Normally it doesn't lead to weight loss. Most of the patients with type 2 diabetes are overweight or obese. They may get some weight loss when the diabetes starts, but not in most of the patients. So if you are having weight loss, you must check your sugar. If it is high, you possibly have it because of diabetes. Otherwise, you should investigate for other causes of weight loss.
You should get the blood test done, ultrasound, chest X-ray, maybe try to rule out every possible.
You have to consult the doctor and look at various factors which may be there.
Right, sir. So why do we call diabetes a silent killer?
Because as I told you that most of the patients with type 2 diabetes will not have any symptoms. So they get diagnosed either during routine health check or they're going for insurance and they get sugar check, or they have some other problems, they develop say chest infection, get the checked for sugar and the sugar. So what happens is, since the people don't get symptoms and they don't get sugar checked regularly, the average delay in the onset of diabetes and diagnosis of diabetes is anywhere between 3 to 7 years. And during this period, these high sugar levels are causing damage. Secondly, because sugar does not lead to much problem, even if you are diagnosed diabetes, there are most of the time you are not having any symptoms. So people don't take it seriously, they control it well, and it gradually keeps on damaging different target organs like heart, like there is an increased occlusion of the coronary arteries, there is blocking of the arteries leading to heart attacks, there can be paralytic attacks, the kidneys can get damaged. So uncontrolled sugar, because it is not causing much problem, it gets neglected, leads to ongoing damage to various target organs, and because of the increased tendency for heart attacks and also because the diabetes patients have silent heart attacks, they will not even know that they have suffered a heart attack. So 20% of the time they will have silent heart attacks. So there is very high risk for sudden deaths and heart related deaths, for which there is no, you know, obvious problem with the diabetes patient.
So you mean to say they don't know the pain? Yeah. Or no, there is no pain?
So you will, you might come across a diabetes patient, when you do the ECG or do an echo, you will see that this patient suffered a heart attack sometime. But if you ask in the history, patient says he never had any
problem.
The reason
being diabetes related damages. Sir, you have taken this question.
So diabetes will lead to kidney disease, which will lead to death.
This was my next question.
Heart disease, which can cause early death. Okay. Paralytic attacks can cause early death. Sudden deaths. Sudden death, sudden cardiac deaths. They are common with the, they are increased in diabetes patients. So that is why it is called a silent killer.
So you mean to say these are all the complications which are associated with the diabetes? So just listing a few, can you please come to the complications which are associated with diabetes?
So the major complications are coronary artery disease and cardiovascular complications, which basically, when we say cardiovascular complications, it includes heart, brain and the peripheral arteries. So there is increased risk of heart attacks, there is increased risk of heart failure, there is increased risk of strokes, there is increased risk of occlusion of blood circulation in the lower limbs, increased risk of diabetic foot, increased risk of lower leg amputations, increased risk of premature cataract and retinal bleeds leading to early blindness, and increased risk of sudden deaths. These are the very important complications. In addition, people who are overweight, they will have increased risk of obstructive sleep disorders, again increased risk of sudden deaths, arrhythmias, so many things.
It affects practically each and
every single part of the
body. Head to toe,
yes.
Sir, there's a question from Asha Kapoor. Is type 1 diabetes reversible?
Type 1 is not reversible as of now. Type 1 diabetes patients, some of the patients, once they are treated with insulin to begin with, they can go into something called honeymoon phase. So they will get back to the normal sugar levels, stay normal for a period of time and then come back to the high blood sugar levels. So this is called honeymoon phase. But reversal of diabetes in type 1 is not reported. It is, type 2 diabetes, yes, there is a possibility of so-called remission, not exactly reversal. When we say reversal, basically, reversal can, now is being discussed as a different parameter. So reversal is that at any point of time in the course of disease, if you move back, say a few steps also, it is, you are reversing. Like you reverse your car, it doesn't mean that you have gone back to the place where you started. But a remission is when you get back into the normal sugar level.
So
right?
In type 1, that is not possible.
No, type 1 it is not reported, yes.
Sir, coming to the next question, how to treat different type of diabetes?
So, when we come to treatment of diabetes, two diseases are very different. Type 1, the treatment is only insulin and nothing else. There are some, studies going on with monoclonal antibodies given very early in the course of disease, which may be helpful. But as of now, we don't have very promising results. So, currently, the treatment is insulin, whether you give this as multiple injections or you use an insulin pump. The mode of delivery of insulin can be different, but the treatment stays insulin. For type 2 diabetes, you have, you can start with so many options because it is a different mechanism. There is increased insulin resistance and decrease in the beta cell function. So you have to improve both. एंड करेंटली एक्चुअली वी नाउ हैव ऑलमोस्ट 12 मैकेनिज्म्स विच आर 12 मेटाबॉलिक पाथवेज विच आर एबनॉर्मल एंड आर लीडिंग टू इंक्रीज ब्लड शुगर. सो वी हैव टू यूज मल्टीपल मेडिकेशंस टू यू नो ट्राई टू नॉर्मलाइज ऑल दीज मेटाबॉलिक एबनॉर्मलिटीज. ऑफकोर्स देयर कम्स अ स्टेज व्हेन नन ऑफ दीज मेडिकेशंस वर्क एंड अल्टीमेटली यू हैव टू एड ऑन इंसुलिन ऑल्सो. बट थिंग्स आर चेंजिंग ऑन टाइप 2 डायबिटीज पाथवेज. सो यू नो वी डोंट नो हाउ लॉन्ग वी विल कंटिन्यू विद दीज स्ट्रेटजीज एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू कीप चेंजिंग. बट वी विल यू नो हैव अ सेपरेट सेशन ऑन हाउ वी ट्रीट डायबिटीज बोथ फॉर टाइप 1 एंड टाइप 2.
क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम माय साइड सर, इज इंसुलिन स्केयरी? इज इंसुलिन एडिक्टिव?
So why are you asking this question?
This is a question repeatedly I get from my patients.
No, so, but you are using insulin yourself. You sir, are giving it to so many patients.
This is the main.
Have you ever found it scary or difficult or painful or anything?
Sir, I always say if I get diabetes, injection will be my first choice. But the thing is, this
it
thing
is I think
the mind of
it is needle phobia. It is not insulin phobia, and you know, it is virtually painless. Insulin injections now are actually state of art technologies. The needles are so thin that they do not cause you know, sting is smaller or much weaker than a mosquito bite, and it's easy to you know inject yourself. And insulin, again, you know, there is lot of scientific research happening and lot of promising data is coming. So most likely in next 2 years time we may be seeing you know insulin injections which are to be given once a day, once a week, or maybe even once a month, and we will be seeing easy to use oral insulin also. So maybe we will be, you know, the needles and pens will be moving in the background in next 3 years time or so.
So this is the reason we try to inject the first dose at our center.
Yeah. So we, and most of the patients are injecting fine. There is no problem.
See, this is a question. See, this questions, these questions I am not taking, sir. I am taking on behalf of patients. Mm. These are a lay-in question. Sir, what is your take on over-the-counter medication for diabetes? Maybe
you
I will
never
not.
Try it.
I will not name anybody.
You should never try it. You should never try it. Diabetes is a serious disease. We consider diabetes as a heart equivalent. So there are studies which have clearly shown that once you get diabetes, your risk of getting a heart attack is same as a person who does not have diabetes and suffered a heart attack. So you are actually, the day you get diabetes, you have suffered damage equal to a heart attack. So you should take diabetes as seriously as you have suffered a heart attack. After suffering a heart attack, you don't go and you know take all these herbal medications and try you know what is being sold on TV screens or newspapers.
But usually, what
and that should
see,
not be done with diabetes also.
But in the current scenario, what we see is after taking all these medications, the patient approaches to you,
and that is why people get more complications.
Yes.
So you have seen, we have so many patients in follow-up.
Yes.
For more than 25 years also now, and doing very fine without any complications. And there are people who end up with us with 5 years or 8 years diabetes and having kidney damage and heart attack and all these things, because the initial okay. There is another important thing, is something called legacy effect. So if you control your sugar levels, if you control your diabetes well in the first 5 to 7 years of disease, you are likely to get much lower levels of complication even 30 years after the disease started. But if your control is bad in first 5 to 10 years, your complication rate will be much higher for rest of your life. So a good glucose control will have a good legacy effect, and bad glucose control will have a bad legacy effect. So you should try to, the day you get diagnosed, you should control your glucose as good or as well as possible and keep it as near to normal as possible, so that you can live a life of say next 50 years without any complication.
एंड व्हाट वी आर सीइंग इज जस्ट द रिवर्स. इनिशियल इयर्स आर वेस्टेड एंड व्हेन द पेशेंट बिकम्स अलर्ट,
दिस पेशेंट हैव बैड लेगेसी ऑफ बैड ग्लूकोज कंट्रोल.
सो वन मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम माय साइड, व्हाट इज योर टेक ऑन देसी ट्रीटमेंट, मेथी दाना, दालचीनी एंड
सो दे आर गुड फाइबर सप्लीमेंट्स.
ओके,
they are so once we say when we are talking of diabetes, so there is something called lifestyle intervention which include modifications in diet and exercise. So these are good diet supplements, but they are not treatment.
So you can have it if so you like it.
No, you should not have everything. First you should have you should study them from authentic information resources, not from Google, not from WhatsApp, not from Facebook only. If you see that something, if you find something is promising, go to a authentic scientific website and read about them, or talk to your doctor, or talk to a dietitian who can guide you properly, and then only take it. Otherwise, it's best to avoid all these things. The basic rule for your diet is that you should have a good, healthy, high fiber, low glycemic index diet. You should eat on time, you should eat consistently, you should not miss your meals, and you should exercise regularly. If you do all these things, you will always be doing fine with your diabetes treatment, provided you are taking whatever medication is also required.
How would you like to sum up today's session, sir?
So first thing is, do not take diabetes lightly. Diabetes is a serious disease. If you get diagnosed with diabetes, take it as seriously as I mentioned earlier that you have suffered a heart attack. But it is actually, if you look at the brighter side, this gives you a warning that you have to change gears, you have to focus on health. And if you focus on health properly, you control your diabetes properly, there is very interesting study called steno-diabetes study. What they did was they took diabetes patients and they put them in two groups. One was they were treated according to standard care, and the other group was treated with very aggressive approach where control of glucose, control of cholesterol, control of blood pressure, aspirin, everything was given, lifestyle intervention was taken. 20 years down the line, the patients who were in the aggressive treatment arm had 8 years increase in the life expectancy. So if you are treating your diabetes well, not only you will have a good quality of life, you will have less risk of complications, and you will increase longevity. So do not take diabetes lightly. If you get diagnosed, there is nothing to worry. You can still live normal life. Normal life does not mean a haywire life, that you do whatever you want to do and you will feel that it is normal. Normal life is a normal healthy life you can live without increasing the risk of complications, and you can live absolutely normal lifespan without much complications, provided you address your diabetes properly. If you neglect it, you are in for bad time. So I think that is the most important message I want to convey.
I think, sir, it was a wonderful session.
Thank you. And I think we will keep this campaign on. We are doing a small effort on our part to educate people whoever get connected on our page about diabetes, so that we can convey this message to whatever number of people. And even if few people benefit, I think we will do our job well. Thank you.
Thank you.